Hey everyone, greetings from Columbus, Ohio. So whenever I'm in a new city, one of the places I like to start whenever possible is at the public market. So I'm at the North Market. It's Columbus's largest public market. It's also the oldest. It's 147 years old. So they have 30 plus vendors in here. The vendors are on the first level. Just take a look around. You got pizza, you got Japanese poke Thai. Then over here you have Moroccan, vegan, then there's also Vietnamese. And I'm sitting in front of a Momo place. The name is Momo Gar, and I got some Momo from there. These are chicken Momo. And then there's also an African place here, Somali to be specific. It's called Hoyos. So I got some mango chicken, I got some goat, and just a bunch of different things I'm gonna try. I also did some shopping earlier. I got some balsamic from the green olive. So yeah, I mean, you can pretty much eat around the world in this market. And from what I've been told, they're gonna be expanding it. So yeah, let's get to trying some of these items. So I'm trying the chicken ginger momo first. Just take a look inside there. It's chicken, onion, little pieces of ginger, and it comes in the tomato sauce. And then the Somali dishes, which I'm really excited to try since I think Safari up in Harlem is the last Somali restaurant I've tried. So I want to try the goat, which is on bone. Okay. I could definitely taste the cinnamon and nutmeg. Again, I mentioned earlier, those are two of the main ingredients in Somali cooking, which is fine by me. But just this place is really something. Great place to start your tour. Just look behind me. You could see the Japanese Kit Kats, the little Pocky boxes off to the side. They even have blueberry at this time. So this is AB. He's from Hoyo's Kitchen, which I just tried the lamb and the chicken from. And this is Muhammad. They are brothers. So they do look alike and they are brothers. And then also there are different spices. This place here, Mini Super, has Ohio maple syrup. But the main thing I wanted to see here at this market was Jenny's. So this was one of my major bucket list stops for this trip. I'm at Jenny's, which I've been buying in Whole Foods and Wegmans for about a decade now. But you may think I'm just like going to a chain, not something local, but that's not true. Because Jenny started here in Columbus. If you take a look up here, that's Jenny. She was an art student at Ohio State, I believe. And this is one of the locations. It started at the North Market, but now we're in the Arts District, the Short North Arts District, I believe it's called. And this is the location here, and I'm trying a couple different flavors. First, I'm trying the buttercream birthday cake. I've been eating this ice cream for years. I've hardly ever had a flavor I didn't like. And if they ask you if you want the waffle cone, you should always try it. So you can see behind me they have the pints, and I'm trying cold brew actually for the first time. And I'm gonna kind of remember, I'm gonna go down memory lane, and I'm gonna try the gooey butter cake, which I have bought in the stores, but I haven't been to St. Louis in a while. It kind of reminds me of that. Like I said, I've pretty much never had a flavor here that I didn't enjoy. Kogo is the bike share program here in Columbus. They happen to have a docking station right across from the Leveque Hotel where I'm staying while I'm in town. So you just grab one of these, it's about a 45 minute time limit, and it's just between $2 and $3. I'm gonna grab one and go check out German Village. German Village starts here at Livingston and 3rd. It goes all the way down past Schiller Park. As you can see, it's on the National Register of Historic Places. This delicatessen's been here a long time, as have a lot of the places along 3rd Avenue. This is a great stretch, and I got here by bike less than 10 minutes from downtown where I'm staying. So Katzinger's definitely has a neighborhood institution feel. They've been here since 1984. Although they're not the oldest in the neighborhood, they definitely have the coolest slogan, which is Matzo Ballen, since 1984. And if you just take a look around here, the walls are pretty much lined with pictures of people who've been here, awards and other accolades from the community here in Columbus. So I'm gonna go with the smoked salmon bagel, which is usually my first choice. So the bagel's toasted, which I always prefer. Sort of reminds me of home, but I also feel like I'm traveling. And the nice thing about this place is, it is basically the northern border of German Village, so it's a great place to start, but then there's a lot more about a mile south of here. I've been trying different restaurants on this trip, and I'm staying at the Levesque, but I'm here with Caroline, who's gonna be the director of operations for a new hotel, which you could read the name off of her hard hat there. So hi, how are you, Caroline?
I'm good there, how are you?
So we got a great skyline picture behind you, and I'd love to know what could guests expect when they stay at this hotel besides the obvious view and proximity to the museum?
Yes, of course. So the best thing about our property is that we're going to have three different restaurants on site. So we'll have a coffee shop called Maldine's, which is themed after the 1920s homecoming queen of Ohio State, which was a cow, which is pretty great. And her name was Maudine. We'll have a Little West Tavern, which will be our main restaurant. And then we'll have a rooftop bar, Brass Eye. And the best thing about these is that they're all their own individual entity and experience just here at the Junta.
Okay, so which floor are we on right now?
We are on our very top floor, which will be our eighth floor.
Okay, and what is going to be here where we are now?
This will be where our rooftop bar is, Brass Eye.
Okay, great. So it looks like it's going to be a combination of indoor and outdoor seating. Is that correct?
That is, yes.
Okay, and I just want to show people a better idea. And I'm assuming some of the rooms are going to have a view like this?
They will, yes. And some will have their own private patios as well.
Okay, so you have an eighth floor restaurant planned, a coffee shop on the ground level,
yes.
And what was the other thing?
Little West Tavern, which will be on our ground level as well.
All right, when do you plan to open?
We'll be opening in mid-May, so around Memorial Day weekend.
Okay, great, best of luck, thank you.
Thank you so much.
I'm at the Pearl, which is in the Short North Arts District. So this is a tavern style restaurant. It says oyster bar, but they also have other fish and seafood. So I'm going for the Arctic Char, which has grilled cauliflower. It also is served over a cauliflower puree. And this is also known for steak, this place. So if you take a look over here, you can see a little breakdown of where the steak comes from, the different cuts. And it's along High Street, which is probably the most walkable street, at least the most walkable street I've seen so far in Columbus. So the Arctic Char, if you've never had it before, it looks more like salmon, but tastes more like a steelhead trout. It's not obviously as popular as salmon, but I try to order it whenever I can. There's so much more I want to try on the menu here, but this is definitely a good start for my first night here. Joy's is a brunch spot in Worthington. They have some really cool drinks, and there's also a small menu. I'm trying the cheesy double crunch tacos. So if you take a look here, I'm going to try to dissect this one for you. This is crispy paratha on the outside, and right on the inside is tortilla. There's lettuce. It's topped with a lot of cheddar cheese. I chose the brisket for the protein. And then I believe there's also Chef Miguel referred to as Oaxacan sauce. So the menu is a really interesting mix of Bengali, Mexican, and New American. The reason is the owner's parents were from Bangladesh, and Chef Miguel, who I just met, is from Oaxaca, which is thought of by many to be the food capital of Mexico. I had a great time there a few years ago. So here's what they look like on the inside. That's the brisket. One thing I'll say about these is they do have a little bit of kick. It takes 3 or 4 seconds to hit, but I really love the way the two breads kind of combine. I don't know if bread's the right word, but the paratha and the tortilla and then the cream on the inside. So I just tried to describe the crispy crunch taco, but I think I have somebody who could do a much better job than me. This is Chef Miguel, who I was referring to. So there's a lot going on with this dish. Can you describe it for me?
Yeah, so this dish got inspired by the But Taco Bell, Chef Abhishek Barua, he grew up eating Taco Bell. And his mom used to bring him all the time Taco Bell. And then when he started working at a restaurant, you know, we get off late and that kind of stuff. And Taco Bell is the only restaurant, sometimes it's the only restaurant that's open. So he used to go and grab some food from Taco Bell. He really loves Taco Bell. So he is like, when he started working at a restaurant, he's like, I need to figure out how to do recreate a dish they really like. So, and the bottom of the taco is, we call it a burrata, which is Chef Abhishek's recipe. So that's it's like a, I would say like a Bengali tortilla. So.
I'm familiar with it because I live in Jackson Heights, Queens. I don't know if you've ever heard of Jackson Heights, but if you're going to find South Asian food in New York, most people are going to tell you to go to Jackson Heights. And there's also a lot of Mexican food there, so it's a really curious mix if you've never been there. Could you tell me a little bit, you were talking about Oaxaca spices.
Yeah, we tried to mix a little bit. Chef Abhishek was like, since you're the chef, you can put a little bit of your Oaxacan spices there. And so basically on the meat, so we smoked the beef first, the brisket, so we like that flavory smoky on the meat, and we add some Oaxacan spices, and we add some Bengali spices too, so we make a little fusion, so it tastes very, very good. You know, but we make our own here, so like I say, we smoke the brisket, and then we add a little bit, we are green sauce and red sauce, so the green sauce is inspired, is a Venezuelan salsa, it's called guasacaca. So we put it on there, we do the lettuce, we share it like Taco Bell, and then we do the red sauce, we call it, which is matcha salsa. I don't know if you're ever familiar with
now,
the matcha
salsa. I associate matcha with like Japanese green tea. Is this something different or is it the same?
No, it's different. This is like a Hispanic salsa, which is made with peanuts and vinegar and some chili crisp, and it's a little bit spicy on it. And at the same time, it's a little bit acidic too, which is brings a really, really good flavors. And then on the top of the dish, we put a smoked cheddar since we have a smoked brisket on the bottom. So we put a smoked cheddar cheese.
Well, it works. That's the important part. It works. And I want to try the other restaurant. So you got a really great city here. I appreciate it.
Yeah. And we're really happy to be here in Worthington. The people here are very supportive. The community is very supportive, so we love it to be here. So if you guys got a chance to try Diet Agni, you know, it's the new restaurant, so.
Well, thank you, Miguel.
No problem, thank you.
So I'm at Agni with Chef Abhishek. I believe this is the second week you're open. Do I have that right?
That is correct. It is our first full week of service.
So this is a really interesting concept. Two people can sit at this table, two servings per night. Do I have that right?
Yeah, we do two or three seatings depending on how busy we are, but we do enjoy having the guests in front of the fire. It was one of the most interesting things that we tried to do, and we're so far the feedback's been great.
So this is a set menu, and I'm trying this dish here. Can you explain this one?
Sure. This is the one dish that I think that is the reason that we have this style of menu, is we always want to encourage people to try a little bit of everything. So this is a little bit of everything. It's inspired by my Bengali heritage and a lot of cooking techniques that I've learned in the past, and has a little bit of the influence of the fire as well, too. It's our Bengali egg chaat, basically. And on the base, it's actually got sweet potato that is grilled inside of the embers till it forms a nice grilled puree. On top of that is a slow-cooked egg. We were inspired by the onsen tamago, so an egg that's normally cooked in the hot springs. We cheat a little, we use sous vide to get it there, but we wanted them all to be consistent. On top of that is chaal muri, the national snack of Bangladesh, which has got puffed rice, it's got chilies, cucumber, tomato, onion, and a good healthy dose of mustard oil. So to Midwesternize it, we took something that people don't normally like around here, spinach, and we deep fried it in a pakoram fashion. So we made a chickpea batter and fried it, baby spinach and baby arugula, topped it with three chutneys, and that is the first course of the evening.
That's the first course of the evening.
That is the first course of the evening.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
So you call this breakfast for dinner?
In a way, it's the best of street snacks and flavors of nighttime in a daytime presentation. Good upside down bowl of cereal, right?
Okay, it's crispy. I like what you did with the spinach. You said that there's a yogurt in there, right?
Yes, the yogurt is for a creaminess. We don't use any other dairy, so normally if you have a dish with eggs, you want to add something creamy to it, so we would use yogurt instead.
Okay, yeah, and there's not much spice to it.
Yeah, it's it is different. It's seasoned, is how I describe it.
Seasonings, okay. So Avishar, when I came to Agni, I was not expecting to have a Italian pasta dish topped with cheese and a vodka sauce. I'd love to hear more about how this ended up on your first menu.
Sure. One of the things that was nostalgic to me in this menu is the story was the first pasta dish that I had as a Bengali American was not a traditional pasta and red sauce. It was a can of SpaghettiOs. It was very dear to me. The flavors of those were comforting. I was like, oh, this is my entry into American cuisine. So we thought, now that we're sharing the story of this is actually that we extrude the pasta in-house using our fancy extruder. We'll chop that up and add a vodka sauce that's based on almost like a makhani sauce. So there is some of that in there. We use vodka, which is not something you would use in Bangladesh because they don't have that over there. The alcohol soluble compounds is all in tomato sauce and we roast over fire, so it adds to the flavor of it. Also, pasta alla vodka is trending this year, so I thought it would be cool to put our play on it. The meatballs on the top are not actually meatballs at all, they're koftas. So it might remind you of Malai kofta. And they're 100% lamb.
I love chicken tikka malai. Am I saying that right?
Chicken tikka masala, maybe?
No, malai.
Oh, you like malai? Okay.
Yeah. So here, you don't even need a spoon for this one.
Yep.
I gotta try this one.
Yeah, go for it.
So it's crispy and soft noodles, right?
Yep. We deep fry some of them on the side because we like the crunchy bits just like the lasagna.
And what is the cheese on top?
It's 25-year-old Parmigiano Reggiano. There's no substitute for that one. So
25 years old. Well, where does the spice come from? I'm feeling it a little bit.
Yeah, so we use both Calabrian chilies and extra hot chili powder. So it's got a little bit of Italian and Bengali influences.
Well, it works.
Awesome.
Thank you very much.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Now I'm outside the city center. I'm in North Columbus, and I'm with Lawrence at Brazilian Grill and Bakery. And Lawrence, this is a really interesting place you got here. You got this kind of restaurant, cafeteria-style place on one side and then a grocery store on the other.
That's right, yeah.
So how long have you been here?
Well, for about 3 years now, taking care of a lot of Brazilian people, a lot of American folks now is starting to come in, which has been great, and a lot of South Americans as well.
Well, I'm not proud to say this, but most of my Brazilian dining experience so far has been at Rodizio's. One great exception in Pittsburgh, but besides that, obviously I think I know what this is. You Brazilians are great with meat.
Yeah, oh yeah.
But you have they're also great with bread, I believe. We have a couple. This is pão de queijo, is that right?
Yeah, pão de queijo, yeah. That's pretty good Portuguese too.
Yeah, non falo português muito bem.
That's not bad.
I've been to Lisbon once. So what do we call this one here?
Oh, so that is bolinho de mandioca.
Oh, that's way too fast.
Bolinho.
Okay. Bolin.
De mandioca.
De mandioca.
And there you go.
What is it inside?
So that's going to be a yuca with ground beef.
Okay, I'm going to try this.
Yeah. Yeah, so
it's really soft, kind of chewy. I love fried yuca. I guess that's what's inside of here.
So you get.
Okay. And then this is more round. What do we have here?
That is coxinha. Coxinha is.
Coxinha.
And that's got chicken and cream cheese inside.
Chicken and cream cheese. Okay.
Yeah. And the reason it's called coxinha, it kind of resembles. Coxinha means drumstick in Portuguese. So
it's like onion shaped.
Yeah, but if you put a little bone, that will be the drumstick.
Okay.
that's why. And that one is actually a white flour base, basically.
You said white flour?
Yeah. So the for the dough, yeah.
I love both. I'm leaning towards this one, which I already forgot the Portuguese name for. I knew cashew milk was a thing. I didn't know cashew juice was a thing.
Yeah, I think everybody knows the nut, right? So in Brazil and in other tropical countries, cashew fruit actually kind of looks like a pear in a way.
So this is not like cashew, the nut?
No, that's actually the fruit. which is super acid. Like, it would burn your face off if you ever had it, like, from a tree. So you kind of have to wait for the right time, and then the nut is, anybody can just go to on YouTube and find a way to get that, to extract that nut to be the way that we do, to roast it. It's explosive, I'll put it that way. It's very different.
Okay.
But that's the fruit.
Well, thank you for letting me try these things. And I am going to try one more. I only know a handful of things. So, muito obrigado.
Obrigado.
Okay, all right, thank you. Merhaba, everyone. I'm at Yemeni Restaurant in Columbus, and I'm here with Naj, and he's prepared a couple of Yemeni dishes for me. Is that right?
Yes, we are.
Okay, so I believe this is hummus with lamb.
Yep, that's our first dish. That's one of the most popular appetizers that we have. It's sautéed lamb. It's cooked with green peppers, onion, cilantro, jalapeno, and garlic, and it serves with hummus and fresh tandoori bread, fresh clay oven bread.
I'm gonna touch it. It's really warm. Yes. And yeah, so it's right out of the oven. And then the this dish here just stopped boiling. But can you explain that one?
This is also as an appetizer. It's a shredded lamb with mashed potato, and it comes a clay bowl. It serves very, very hot, you know.
Okay, yeah. So these are both appetizers then?
Yes.
So how would I eat this?
You scoop it up and you eat it with fresh bread.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm just gonna tilt down a little bit so we could kind of see what we're doing. So we got the fresh bread. Could this be touched?
It's still hot, so okay. You're gonna have to get it with the spoon.
Okay.
All right.
So we got that right there.
Yep.
And just put the bread in.
Yep, you gotta dip it in.
Okay. So here's what it looks like. I'm gonna give it a try. And is this something like back home you would eat with every meal?
Yep, it's in every meal.
Mmm, tomato?
Yes, it's tomato sauce.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's not spicy, is it supposed to be?
Nope, it's not spicy. We serve the spices on the side. This is the spices size that we have.
Okay, 1 to 10, how spicy is it?
It's about an 8.
Okay, yes. All right. I may forego that one,
but
I believe you also eat this with the bread as well.
The hummus with meat, yes.
All right. Well, thank you very much for the little introduction.
Thank you.
And definitely check this place out if you're ever in Columbus.
Thank you. It was a pleasure having you in here.
Stories on High is Columbus's highest rooftop bar. It's on the 28th floor of the Hilton Downtown Columbus, which is the largest hotel in the city. So they have a pretty extensive drink menu here. Amazing views as you can see behind me. And I'm starting off with the non-alcoholic espresso martini. And my server's favorite item on the menu is the Wagyu Nigiri. So you can't see it, but there's caviar underneath the beef between the rice and the meat. And then on top, there's an extremely generous portion of truffle. So the truffle definitely adds a layer of richness to the dish. The caviar doesn't stand out as much, but the truffle's definitely something I like having on top of it. And also, you can't go wrong with Wagyu, and as long as the rice is good, this is something definitely you should try up here. So Fire is the ground level restaurant at the Hilton Columbus downtown. You can see the menu right here, and it's named after fire, which you can see burning behind me. And Chef Sebastian is from Argentina, so as soon as I heard this, I had to order the skirt steak. So here it is, a 10-ounce skirt steak with grana padano cheese on top over a bed of arugula. And Chef Sebastian, like a lot of people from Argentina, is also really into hard rock. So the chimichurri sauce is called Chimi Hendrix. It's his own version of probably the most popular steak sauce in Argentina, and also probably Uruguay and other Latin American countries as well. So I want to talk about the chimichurri sauce. Actually, Chimi Hendrix, I keep confusing them. But anyway, it rocks. It's not spicy, There's a sweetness to it. I definitely taste the garlic, but just, I want you to take a look around this place. This hotel has art from local artists. You can watch the show behind you. I love my the table I'm at here. And again, it's like a really convenient downtown location, and it's a newer restaurant as well. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please click subscribe. I've had a great time here in Columbus. I have some trips coming up, of course. I got Wilmington, Delaware coming up in April, then deeper into the spring, I'm gonna be hopefully heading back up to Toronto, Ontario, Canada. And I'm gonna enjoy the rest of my Jenny's ice cream and say goodbye.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I will try not to sing out of key. Oh, baby.